Hey friends! I'm so excited to tell you about one of my favorite artists, Judith Scott.
Judith Scott was an American artist who created sculptures by wrapping unexpected objects in yarn and string. Judith was born in Cincinnati in 1943 along with her twin sister, Joyce. Judith was born with Down syndrome and she lost her hearing when she was a baby. This meant that Judith needed extra help learning and communicating. People at that time didn't know as much as we do now about Down syndrome, and they didn't know how to teach Judith. So sadly, she was separated from her family for years. But her sister Joyce never forgot about her twin, and as an adult, she helped Judith move to California to live with her. Joyce encouraged Judy to make art at a studio called Creative Growth Art Center. At first, Judith tried painting and drawing, but she didn't like it very much. It didn't seem like she was going to become an artist, but then one day, Judith watched a visiting artist teach a sewing class, and she was inspired. Judith invented her own type of art, wrapping different objects with string and yarn and strips of fabric. She chose her colors very carefully, and sometimes hid smaller objects in her wrapping. Her art became famous, and now her sculptures are in museums all over the world. Judith loved wearing fancy hats and headscarves, and she found inspiration in magazines. She and her sister Joyce went to all of her art exhibits together. I love the bright colors and interesting textures of Judith's art, and I love trying to figure out what objects are underneath all the wrapping. Can you tell what this one is? Sometimes you can tell, and sometimes her sculptures just look very mysterious and magical. Her art reminds me how important it is to include everyone and to give everyone a chance to express themselves. Let's look at some ways we can be inspired by Judith Scott's art. One way to make art inspired by Judith Scott is gathering string, yarn, thread, rubber bands, pipe cleaners, strips of fabric, and finding objects to wrap. You could look in nature for twigs and pine cones, or you can find something that might end up in the trash or recycling bin. An easy object to start out with is a cardboard shape. I cut a heart out of cardboard and I cut notches in the sides to make it easier to wrap. I wrapped my heart with yarn, ribbon, and string. I also used a pipe cleaner and put some beads on it. You can experiment with weaving and tying knots. If you don't have any yarn, you can draw an object you'd like to wrap instead. I used a Sharpie to draw a chair, a shopping cart, and my sewing machine. After you've drawn your objects, use something colorful to draw yarn. I tried crayons, colored pencils, and markers, and I layered my colors the same way Judith Scott layers her string and yarn. I drew some dots to be beads, and I experimented with drawing holding multiple colored pencils at once. I kept going until my drawings were covered with beautiful colors and wavy lines, just like Judith Scott's sculptures. Thanks for watching, and I hope that you find lots of inspiration in the art of Judith Scott.